Last talk of the day, so enjoy here for the final send-off. Just our three speakers, Emily Defines, a psychology major, Bree Schultz is a HDFS, so Human Development Family Science major, and Miranda Henneman is a psychology major, and I will turn it over to you three.
Okay, so our study was on the effects of interaction with therapy dogs on stress and anxiety in undergraduate nursing students. So as I'm sure most of us have experienced this one too many times, stress in college students is frankly inevitable. However, research has shown that nursing students in particular have the most intense workload and therefore the highest stress level among majors on college campuses. According to Gibbons in 2010, there are many negative ways that college students cope with stress, such as drug use and avoidance altogether. So we wanted to conduct a study on one of the recently found positive strategies, therapy dogs. Previous researchers have assessed the impact of interaction with therapy animals on college student stress. Silcio Mano and his colleagues in 2011 compared coping strategies such as breathing sessions and meditation to interaction with these dogs. They found that the interaction with therapy dogs was a more beneficial and effective coping strategy in managing stress in college students. In our proposed study, we tested the effect of interaction with therapy dogs on stress and anxiety in comparison to nursing students not exposed to therapy dogs. We hypothesized that participants who interacted with these therapy dogs would report a higher reduction in stress and anxiety than those who listened to music. So originally we had intended on working with sophomore students because after a meeting with Dr. Alnasser, who's the director of nursing here at Mount, he stated that second year students tend to be the most stressed at Mount Union. Unfortunately, after conducting our initial study, we had some schedule complications and were lacking participants, so we had to switch some of our study around. Our final participant pool was made up of freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and senior undergraduate nursing students. We only had a total of 19 participants, which included 18 females and only one male. The mean age of these participants was 21.84, with a standard deviation of 3.2. We recruited them with the assistance of Dr. Alnasser.
So our study involved a repeated measuring design with one between subjects independent variable with two levels. The between subjects independent variable was the intervention, and the two levels were listening to music and interaction with therapy dogs. The repeated measure was time, and the dependent measure were stress and anxiety. So the materials that we provided for the participants, first off was the informed consent form, and we did ours with a pre-test questionnaire as well as a post-test questionnaire. So these two questionnaires that we used the perceived stress scale. So this scale included 10 items that measured the degree to which situations in one's life were appraised as stressful. And these participants indicated how often the item had occurred within the past 3 days by marking a choice on a 5-point Likert scale from never to very often. So a low scale meant less stress and a high scale meant higher stress. Anxiety was assessed by using the Burns Anxiety Inventory. So this included 33 items that asked about anxious feelings, thoughts, and also physical symptoms of anxiety. Participants responded to this inventory by marking a choice on a 4-point Likert scale from not at all to a lot. And they also did this thinking about the past 3 days as well. So a low score meant low anxiety, a high score meant high anxiety. A computer was used as well to access Pandora, which was needed for the meditative music group. And we chose a station. It played nature sounds of sleep and relaxation. And then we also had two dogs that accompanied us in our study as well. And those two dogs came from the Stark County Humane Society. And as well as at the end of the study, we provided them with a debriefing form as well. So the participants all gathered in one room to start off with in Gallagher Hall, and that's where we distributed the informed consent forms. After they signed and filled out those informed consent forms, they started doing the pretest questionnaires, which meant the perceived stress scale and the Burns Anxiety Inventory. Then the participants split off into So the therapy dog group entered one room and they were instructed to just get as comfortable as possible, sit and play with the dogs while they studied or worked on homework. And this lasted for 45 minutes. The participants in the music group, they were also instructed to study or do homework while listening to the music that we provided for them, and they were allowed to position themselves in whatever way that they wanted to, so whether that was sitting at a desk or on the floor, we didn't mind, and that one also lasted for 45 minutes. After that, during both interventions, I should say, we also instructed them to limit conversation with each other because we just wanted them to focus on the interventions that they were participating in. And after the interventions, the participants also completed the post-test questionnaires, which also included the perceived stress scale again and the Burns anxiety inventory.
All right, so here's a little chart from our results section for perceived stress. It shows the mean and standard deviations. The mean showed a decrease from pre to post. And then we also had an increase in standard deviation for music, along with a decrease in standard deviation for dogs. In our study, we used a repeated measure, ZANOVA. We concluded that there was a significant effect from time from pre to post test. However, we found that the mean scores for both therapy dogs and music groups were not significant, along with the interactions between time and intervention groups. And then here's the results on the anxiety. We used the Burns Anxiety Inventory, and we found that it showed a decrease in means and standard deviation for both the music group and dog groups, again, from pre to post test. And then here, again, we used a repeated measure, ZANOVA, to conclude that the effect of time from pre to post was also significant here. We had also found that the mean scores for therapy dogs and music groups were not significant, along with the interaction between time and intervention groups. So overall in our study, we found that the hypothesis was not supported. The interaction with therapy dogs did not actually decrease stress or anxiety more than listening to music prior or before the exam that they were taking. However, we did find that both groups reported less anxiety along with perceived stress from pre to post test. And we also found that the interaction between time and group was not significant for both variables. Maybe with a larger sample size, we could have seen some interaction, but with the limited amount of participants in the first study, the sample was drastically small. So our previous research that we read over before this experiment produced like a lot of different results, but we did find some research that had the same outcome as our original study. And obviously further research will be required, but both interventions did in fact work because there was less in anxiety and stress overall through the experiment.
So although there were a lot of positives to our study, there were also some limitations that we had found that would benefit future research. One of the major ones was how few students we had participating in our study. This resulted in the removal of a key dependent measure, which was the exam performance. Originally we had intended on testing the exam performance and comparing it to the stress and anxiety levels that we had found. And this left us having to recruit from a wide range of students. Also, we had a very small sample size with only one male. So this resulted in not much diversity.